Hello viewers, in this video you'll learn how to enable data layer on Shopify store, and we won't use any app to enable data layer. We will use some JavaScript code to enable data layer on our Shopify store. From the previous video we have learned how to create a Google Tag Manager account and integrate with our Shopify store. We already integrate our Google Tag Manager account with this Shopify store. Right now in this video we'll learn how to enable data layer for this store. Before enabling data layer on this store, let's check if we have a data layer enabled on this store or not. Okay, just I'm copying this URL, then go to Google Tag Manager and click preview so that we can check if we have got some data from our website. Okay, click connect, then open a product page like I'm opening this one. Then see this, we have successfully connected our Google Tag Manager account, and if we go to data layer section we can see we have not got any data from our website here. Also if we click on add to cart, then check no data loaded here, and also if we click checkout or make a purchase, or if we also go to our home page and click on buy it now, no data in our data layer. So let's see how to enable data layer and got all the information from our website here. Viewers, you can see I have a presentation here. We can follow this presentation to enable the data layer on our Shopify store. You can get all the code from also Google. You can search if you search this, and you can see GitHub account, and here you can see data layer all pages code here, and also you can follow this instruction. And if you can't enable data layer by using all of this instruction and by using all of these codes, you can contact me and I will help you to connect data layer with my paid service. Okay, let's see. So first of all, we have to copy this name, data layer all pages. Then we have to go our online store themes, then snippet, and add a new snippet. Let's do it. Shopify, then click on online store, then themes, then we have to click three dot and edit code. Okay, then go to snippet section. Here you can see snippet section, then click and add a new snippet, then give it a name. I'm copying and pasting this, just copy and paste data layer all pages, then click done. Okay, now we have to paste a code from our documentation. I'm just opening this all pages code snippet. Now if we go to closing section here, you can see we have to change this Google Tag Manager code. So right now I'm copying this full code, just Ctrl A, then copy, then go to your Google Shopify store data layer all page section, then paste it. Now just we have to change this GTM code, and we have to use our own GTM code. So I'm copying my GTM code from here. This is my GTM code, then just replace this one. Okay, now we can click save. Okay, we have successfully created a snippet, and next see what to do. Okay, now second step, we have to copy this code. It's called data layer first call code. Then just copy this code and go to our Shopify theme section and theme.liquid file. Then we have to paste this before the closing head tag. Okay, Let's do this. We have to find out the theme.liquid file. Here you can see theme.liquid file. Just click on theme.liquid file, and here is the theme.liquid file. And you can see head section started from here. Then we have to find out our closing head tag. Just scroll down and we can find out the closing head tag. Viewers, you can see here is our closing head tag. Also, you can search this tag by typing this small tag name. You can see this closing head tag already highlighted. Okay, now we have to copy the paste the code that we just copied from here, and I'm copying this one again. Okay, just copy and paste this before the closing head tag. Okay, I have pasted and then click save. Okay, then we have to paste this code again on the additional script box. Okay, go to additional script, just exit. Then we have to go to our checkout page settings, then checkout, then scroll down. We will find out additional script box here. Then we have to paste the code again here. Okay, then click save. After that, we have to copy a Shopify checkout page data layer code from here. If we open this, now you can see here we have to also change our GTM code. Like, we have to change this code and add our own Google Tag Manager code from here. Let's do it. I'm just copying this code. Then we have to paste this on the additional script box. Okay, so I'm here, additional script box, then just click enter and paste this code and find out the GTM code. We have to change this and add our GTM code. Okay, also you can search GTM, then you will find this one easily. And I'm copying this one again, our GTM code. Then go to Shopify additional script box and change this one. Just paste. Okay, after that we have to click save. Okay, just we have to follow three steps. Just need to copy three code and paste them in our store. Okay, now we can see or we can check it's working or not. Just click on preview. Then connect our store and let's see. We'll get add to cart, checkout, and others information here, and we can see data layer is enabled or not. Okay, let's see. Okay, I'm going to open a product, and you can see if I click on add to cart, we will get an add to cart event here. Here you can see we get already add to cart event here, and if we go to data layer section, you can see event, and event name is add to cart. Also, you can see a view item event here. Also, you can see first time visitor event here. We are getting all of this information from the data layer, and we just installed the data layer code on our store. You can also enable your data layer and track your valuable event from your store. And if you can't do this by yourself, then contact me. I will help you to set up or install data layer for your Shopify store or WordPress or any other store.